Hello fellow technicians. In the today video, we will be learning how to clean easy, what no, I mean how to unsolder easy the metallic shields on the 11 models in a very easy way, without using the heat gun. What you will need is a soldering copper tip, something like this, thin scratchet from both sides, so it will penetrate between small places well. Because I already have such iron tip, you will see it under my microscope. So first is turn on the soldering iron, let it warm up, and add around the shields some little bit small amounts of flux. It's like making it wet with flux around the shield. After we added the flux, make sure you have, let me take a small part, make sure you have QuickAlloy from CyberDoc LLC website. This is one of the best low melt solder. Mine is a little bit old, but it still works. In fact, this is the one which CyberDoc LLC have sent it to me a bunch of years ago. And I still have some from him. So we just resolder the shield with QuickAlloy and going around. Like this. Also the corners of the shield, make sure to solder them. So let me try lift out the shield after I have soldered it with low melt alloy. Let me add me more flux because I feel the QuickAlloy did not penetrate well. It does not go off because I feel I did not add more of this QuickAlloy. Also I see that this solder is old and it breaks. So make sure you have some new QuickAlloy. I gave more temperature on the soldering iron and will try to lift the shield out. Okay, I see it. As you can see, the shield has unsoldered. You can do a little of cleaning of soldering of solder. But I will do that later. And make sure to not touch any components with QuickAlloy. Because that is not desired outcome. Okay, let's do the same with the second shield. I have a drop of QuickAlloy which I didn't use yet. So I will just dip every time in this drop of solder, my soldering iron. add flux. Let me see. This shield you will not be able to wield between the NAND. So we will just use the bending like a wire method. Which we did with the SIM slot on the iPhone XS. I see that my soldering iron does not penetrate well. Between these components. Maybe I should have scratched. Because it's not prepared from the previous work. I will try and see if the shield goes off. Yes, it lifts, but the but because we did not solder between NAND, it lifts hard. So I will take with my nail and lift it slowly and play a little bit. Okay, just like that. I have touched a copper store, but that is not big of a problem. I will fix it later. In fact, I will add the normal solder. And re-solder it. So there is only one shield on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. One small shield, which we also can unsolder it in the same way. afraid there is a space between this capacitor, which you can't penetrate easy. So we will have to play a little here. Okay, just so hold the soldering iron in this place and the solder will go by itself in this small place. So let's try to play again with this shield, like we did with that one. Okay, now we just bend it like a wire. And that's it. We took off all the shields. Fuck, I have touch a capacitor. But that is not a problem. We will fix it later. Okay, that's it, guys. If you want to learn more, visit our site iTesla Solutions, and for components and QuickAlloy and other useful stuff, visit CyberDoc LLC. Thanks for watching. Sorry for my bad English also. Please subscribe, like and share so that we can be found by other technicians. Have a good day.